type 1 diabetes. So probably the simplest way of thinking about it is, you know, it's a type of diabetes where your body's not making insulin. Most people think of it as the diabetes they're born with or sort of get in childhood. That's not always the case. So we definitely have people who are diagnosed later in life. But usually it's kind of the diabetes where your body's not making insulin, and so you're dependent on some sort of insulin setup to live, essentially. Really, the big thing is insulin in some form. So, you know, some people inject insulin, some people use insulin pumps, but really the mainstay of it is some sort of insulin administration. So it can make it a little bit challenging sometimes, and I think it's a lot of work. But there are some really cool technologies and really cool advances that we just didn't even have 10 years ago that make it more manageable. Probably the biggest thing that we do is a lot of CGMs that are sort of continuous glucose monitors. And so there's different types, but really they give up to the minute blood sugar readings. And so instead of having to check your finger all the time, they really give you continuous information on how your blood sugars are doing. And so you can make adjustments. And then some of the newer pumps that are coming out, and one of them that is already out, actually kind of bypass people to some degree and let the pump make changes based on the blood sugar readings that you get. And so cutting out some of the work, but it's still a lot of work involved. Really the short answer is insulin helps you break down the food that you eat into the sugar that you would actually want to function. And so, you know, the sugar you need for your brain and for your cells and things like that. And so it lets your body use that fuel. It depends on the type 2, but I would say by and large, probably the biggest difference is in type 1, people don't make any insulin. In type 2, usually they make some insulin. And really where that comes into play is, you know, type 2 can be on insulin too. So it's not that, you know, if you have type 2 diabetes, you don't have insulin medication that you're taking, but it just, it generally gives us other medications to work with. And I would say, you know, with type 2 diabetes, the diet and exercise part maybe plays a little bit more into the treatment part. You know, diet and exercise is a big part of anybody, not with, you know, with or without diabetes. But certainly with type 2, it plays a little bit more of a central role because we know people don't process sugars as well. And so any little bit of exercise and diet helps that work better.